Hi everyone, welcome back. Are you looking out to see the appointments of more than one person on a single calendar? Well, if that is what you are looking for, then you must watch this video till end to learn about how to add appointments of multiple resources to the React scheduler. Say for example, here you can see the scheduler displaying various appointments in different colors. Each of these colors represent that this appointment belongs to a specific person. Now, in this video, I will let you know how to add such appointments of multiple resources to the React scheduler. First, let me clear what the term resource refers here in the phrase multiple resources. The term resource in the scheduler context can be anything like a person, task, or any object that exhibits action over the time period. Say for example, you can look at the room scheduler here, where each room in office premise is displayed as an individual resource row and its appointments are grouped together on the same row. You can also look at this doctor's appointment scheduler as another example, where each doctor can be termed as a resource. So, from these examples, you can easily understand that the resource can be anything like a project, a person, a thing, or any valid task that may vary based on the application scenarios where the scheduler is being used. You can differentiate the appointments of each resource with different colors. Now, in this video, I will proceed to show you how to define the resource data to the React scheduler through code example, and here, I'm not going to group them on the layout. Rather, I will simply show you how to add the appointments of multiple resources on the same scheduler layout and differentiate them with different colors. If you want to know how to add appointments to the React scheduler, you can look on to my Getting Started video to know its basic steps. Also, I will share with you the reference link of that video in the description part below. Now, I will proceed to show you how to add appointments of multiple resources to the React scheduler. As a first step, within the app.tsx file, I will define the resource property. For that, I need to inject the resources directive and resource directive from Synfusion EJ to React schedule package, and then I need to define resources directive tag which accepts one or more resource directive subtags within it. And here, I have planned to add single level resource with its options, so I simply defined a single resource directive tag inside the resources directive tag. This resource directive supports a huge number of sub options within it, so let me show you those options one by one. The first option is field. I have assigned the value as the resource ID to the field option. This value indicates the resource ID fields to be mapped from the event object. Here, I have added the resource ID field to this event object and assigned some applicable ID values. Say for example, I have provided the value 1 for this field, 2 for second field, and 3 for third field. So later, I will say what this number represents. Now, this resource ID is simply a resource field to be mapped with the event data source. The next option is title. You can see here that I have provided the title as resource name. The value of this title will be displayed as the label for resource field on the editor window. And the next option is the name property, where I have provided the value as resources for it. This option will be utilized while working with the grouping concept. As I'm not going to include the grouping option here, therefore, I have no work with this name option in this example, but I will tell you how it works. Whatever name that you assign for the resource should be unique always to identify that resource from the huge collection of resources. So, using this unique name, I can group them on the scheduler layout, and I will show this step in my next video of grouping concept. So, now I will continue with the other options of resources. Next comes the three important fields, text field, ID field, and color field. These are the mapper fields of resource data source that you specify for the resource collection. Here, I will map these field names as name, ID, and color, which I am going to define for the resource data source fields as well. Now, I will define the resource data source. For that, let me define an object variable, and here you can see it contains the array of objects where each object is holding three fields, namely name, ID, and color, which I have shown in my previous step of the resource field mapping. The field name should be same as the one I provided in these mapper fields. And here, you can see the names John, Steve, and James and I have provided the unique ID and color for these three resources. Now, let me assign this resource collection to the data source property of the resources. So, within this resource directive tag, let me assign this resource collection to the data source property. As I said before, I will tell you now why I have set the resource ID field values like this within this appointment data source. Here, you can see that I have assigned this resource ID field as 1, which means that this appointment belongs to the resource whose ID value is 1. So now, I can say that this particular appointment belongs to the resource John as its ID matches with the value 1. Similarly, I can also say this particular appointment belongs to the resource Steve as its ID matches with the value 2. Also, this appointment belongs to the resource James as its ID value matches with the value 3. Okay, now all is set. So, look at the output scheduler now. You can see the appointments displayed on same scheduler with different colors. And when you double click on this appointment, you can see the editor window getting opened. Here, you can see the resource name as John, which implies that the appointment belongs to John. Similarly, when I double click on this appointment, you can see that the resource name as Steve, which implies that this particular appointment belongs to the resource with the ID 2. Alright, now let's have a quick recap about this session. We have seen how to add appointments of multiple resources to the React scheduler, where you simply need to define the resource data source and map them with the required appointments. Now, grouping them visually on the scheduler is just one step ahead and also includes some additional options, which I will cover in my next video. If you find this video as useful, then click the like button and subscribe to our channel too. Thank you once again for watching this video.